Let me say thank you to Ma'am Nina for this opportunity to speak on IT because IT is really close to my heart and it's really one of my advocacies. I enjoy litigation, but IT is something that is really special for me. So I, okay. And also thank you to Genevieve Aquino for linking me to CIRCA. Thus, I'm here today. I'm supposed to speak on intellectual property and biotechnology. Pero, marami bang ano dito, biotech? May biotech background? By training? So I will not fake it. Because I will be embarrassing myself. You will know more than I do. You know more than I do. So I'll just stick with IP, then a bit on IP as applied in biotechnology. If you have any questions, feel free to ask at any point. But as Ma'am said earlier, baka mas maganda kung sagubo na lang. So, there are, my talk today has two parts. First will be on IT, general IT, and then on biotechnology. So, who has IT background here? Yes, sir, my IT background. Good. Okay, that's good. Who else? IT. I guess the researchers, no? I mean, you are already familiar with IT. To ensure that your work is protected at least. So first part, for those who are not yet exposed to IP, would be discussion on intellectual property. What is it? What is the role of IP? What are the main kinds of IP? Okay, not so much on IP practice. Okay, so they say that intellectual property is a product of the intellect. Okay, it's the output of your creation that has value. Well, kahit naman walang value, intellectual property pa rin yun. Pero kung walang value, ano sige yun, diba? So, let's discuss something that has value. Okay. These rights include those that are available to protect your creation from unauthorized use by others. So, for example, when we say patents, yung patent, siya yung protection. Yun yung intellectual property right. Okay. So, it's not the object. Yun yung protection natin. So, IP is distinct from the property to which it is attached. If there is one thing that all of us should remember, it's this line. Never mind if you don't understand what patent is, what trademark is, what copyright is. Let the lawyers and the IP office handle that. But all of us should know that IP is different from the property. Yun yung pinaka-basic talaga. Owning the physical object is different to owning the IP relevant to that object. Before I go there, for example, you buy an iPhone, diba? You buy the iPhone, but you're not buying the intellectual property rights. The intellectual property rights is still owned by Apple. Kaya mas mayaman sila sa atin. Consumer lang talaga tayo. But we, so we own the device, we can sell the device, but the IP rights. Remain with the owner, okay, the creator, or the person who commissioned the work, right? So this is my favorite example of what can go wrong if you do not understand the importance of IP or the importance of treating and understanding IP as an asset. So, yung mga mahilig sa kotse, Rolls Royce, di ba? Yung Rolls Royce natin ngayon, do we know that Rolls Royce right now has no relation whatsoever to Rolls Royce from 1903. Or kung maliman, kaya nag-start yung Rolls Royce. Ang Rolls Royce ngayon, ang may-ari dyan, BMW. Diba? Hindi naman ako mahilig sa kotse. Kasi ako, fiesta lang naman yung didedrive ko. Pero yung mga mahilig sa kotse would understand that it's the car. When you say Rolls Royce yan, diba? Mga diplomat lang pwede yung sumakay dyan. So, when it was put up for sale in 1997, there were two entities who were interested in buying it. BMW and Volkswagen. Dalawang entities na yan. Volkswagen offered a higher price. No? So, you would think that it won the bid. So, akala niya, sabi ni Volkswagen, mas mahal naman yung tinender ko. So, what do I get out of my $790 million? So, a factory, 2,400 skilled workers, the Bentley trademark, the Rolls-Royce trademark, and a continuous access to engine supply. By the way, ano yan, backstory yan, the engines are being supplied by BMW. Si BMW yung magawa yung engine ng Rolls-Royce. Unfortunately, ang abogado ni, ano, abogado ni Volkswagen, hindi siguro siya IP lawyer. Hindi niya chinek yung kontrata. Hindi niya nakita na may isa pang entity, si Rolls-Royce PLC, that owns the Rolls-Royce trademark. So, inibenta yung sold, hindi, sige, benta yung factory, benta yung maskil workers, but not the Rolls-Royce, trademark. E tayo, for example, the consumers, we don't actually buy the product, we buy the name. Diba? Lalo yung mga brand conscious dito. The mat, the bags, right? We're not buying the device. Sometimes, well, at least in our office, the phone is being supplied by the office. Because otherwise, I will not buy an iPhone. It's too expensive. But right, we're buying the name, right? So in this case, although Volkswagen paid the price, they were not able to get the Rolls-Royce trademark. So away ko ni Volkswagen and BMW. Kasi si BMW, dahil siya yung nagsusupply ng engine, meron din siyang agreement with Rolls-Royce na meron siyang parang first right over the Rolls-Royce trademark. So nahati ngayon, yung body, yung katawan ng car is owned by Volkswagen. But the name, the brand was owned by BMW. So hati, sobrang gulo. So eventually, there were some negotiations. Ano nangyari? Okay, so si Volkswagen had the right to use Bentley and Rolls-Royce trademarks and to make Rolls-Royce and Bentley cars up to January 1, 2003 lang. So iba na yung mga Rolls-Royce na yun, iba din yung Rolls-Royce before that. Okay, so imagine, diba? Parang nightmare yun, nakala mo nagbayad ka ng $790 million and you only have the right over the mark until 2003, okay? So, kailangan may due diligence talaga, may understanding of what IP is and what it's not, okay? Okay. Unfortunately, I'm a lawyer, so I have to go to the legal basis. It's something that makes people sleep, but it's something that I have to mention. So the basis of our intellectual property rights may be found in Section 10 of our Constitution. There are some efforts to change our Constitution, but for now it's still good. So let's read it. Section 10 says science and technology are essential for national development and progress. Okay. Etc., etc. So there is an acknowledgement by our framers of the Constitution that science and technology are essential for nation building. Okay. Sana lang pondohan talaga nila, di ba? Para. And then, okay, so the Congress may provide for incentives, tax deductions. Do we experience, have we experienced this, like for UPLB, availed of incentives, tax deductions for inventions created by Filipino inventors. Meron tayong Filipino Inventors Act. It's a very obscure law. I'm not sure if UPLB avails of that. But there is that law, poorly crafted. But there are beneficial provisions in that, ano, in that law. So you can look it up. Essentially, parang free siya from tax for the manufacturer for the first 10 years of commercial launching. May mga ganung ano siya. So, you can show it. Okay, the state shall regulate the transfer and promote the adaptation of technology from all sources for the national benefit. So, now we have the Technology Transfer Act. So, supposedly clear na yung mga sharing, ownership of inventions that are funded by the government. Okay, and we also have the Magna Carta for scientists, right? Okay. So in short, science and technology is equal to national development and progress. Therefore, the state shall promote and give priority to research and development, education, and regulate technology transfer. What is the role of IP? You can find that in the IP code. So I will not read it accessible naman online. Okay, so this one's really important for me. It really depends on your advocacy, on what you stand for, on the level of development that the country has. Some people, if you ask them, is IT good? Then they say no, because it really creates monopoly. Yun yung pinaka-simple sagot ng mga anti-IT rights, diba? But if you are from a developed country and you are a big pharmaceutical company, of course you want IT, because it gives you protection, right? So in one briefing paper submitted to the USAID in 2003, so medyo positive yung comment nila. They were saying that on the micro level, incentivizes the researchers to do more work, to innovate, because they are rewarded by a strong IT policy. On the macro level, it also encourages foreign investment, diba? Because yung mga, let me notice with our clients, before they file patent applications in the Philippines, they would ask, how is enforcement in the Philippines? How is your judiciary, diba? How long does it take for a case to be resolved? Things like that. So, very important for clients to know all these things before they decide whether to file a patent application in the Philippines. Otherwise, kung madilim lang mapalang mangopya sa Pilipinas, or there is no way to enforce your IP rights, and what's the point of filing a patent application in the Philippines, for example? So, the intellectual property system also creates a framework in which developing countries can participate in the economic activities of the developed world. So right now, we have, for example, for trademarks, we have the Madrid Protocol. So for the Madrid Protocol, you can file applications in multiple countries. They say it's cheaper because some stages are actually consolidated, as opposed to filing different applications parallel applications in different countries. So in a way, we have observed that notwithstanding all this brouhaha going on in the country, a lot of our clients are actually filing applications abroad. Hindi katulad ng unang panahon, karamihan ng mga kliyente namin ay foreign clients filing applications in the Philippines, internationally well-known brands. But now we have local clients filing applications abroad. So that means good business din, di ba? And now it's easier, it's more accessible for local entrepreneurs to secure IP protection abroad. Whether it's trademarks or patents. Sa patents naman, meron tayong, si Sir, baka alam niya, meron tayong PCTs. It's also easier to secure patent protection. Well, not easier to secure, it's easier to file patent applications through the PCT. Okay, pero iba yung sinasabi ng UK, isang article submitted prepared for the UK Intellectual Property Office and the UK Department for International Development. So it says that stronger IPRs seem to influence the decisions of individual firms in developed countries by encouraging them to export, invest, and transfer their technologies through licensing in developing countries. It also found that stronger IPRs can hamper access to medicines in developing countries and do not necessarily encourage pharmaceutical innovation that responds to developing country needs. So what did the Philippines do? We have the Congress enacted the Cheaper Medicines Act. So embodied in that law are stringent requirements before medicines can be patented. Kasi napansin nila yung mga pharmaceutical companies pala. Depende siguro if anybody here works in a pharmaceutical company, you may have another position. But others are saying that there are strategies to essentially secure a perpetual monopoly or protection over the same product. So for example, it's a blockbuster drug instead of a yung monopoly kasi bawal, diba? Pero yung batas natin sabi, sige, ito permissible monopoly. 20 years lang ha. 20 years, bawiin mo lahat ng investment mo, ginawa mo. 20 years from filing, pwede ka magkaroon ng monopoly. So permissible monopoly yan. But what others are doing, IT owners are doing, magaling sila. So they write certain patent applications in a way that would look like they are different, but in fact, they cover the same product. So parang perpetual monopoly siya. So the Trigger Medicines Act aims to curb that. So we now have stringent requirements to be able to secure patent protection for medicine at least. Kasi medicine may public interest aspect yun. Nevertheless, from a developing country perspective, IT may be useful in several levels. So as a resource in research and development, do we use this, yung mga patent for the researchers, Okay. So yung time ko ng college, wala pa kami ganyan. Di ba merong SPASNet, yung WIPO na database, USPTO, na medyo mas mahirap gamitin, pero meron din sila free online database. That would have been easier then if we had that, di ba? But now, it's really easier. My keyword search, everything, then you'd be able to see what's there. You don't work on that, kasi pareho na kayo, di ba? You can choose something that's different, or if not different, a modified version, a better version, di ba? So you can use it as a resource. And then it also makes the access to technology and innovations in the public domain easier. So this also means that businesses can create or craft their strategies. So for example, kita nila, for example, iPhone. Kita nila kung ano ginagawa niya, no? Ginagawa ni Samsung. Ah, papunta siya sa ganung technology. Or si iPhone, what was in the news a few weeks ago? Hindi na phone eh. Iba niyong technology niya, di ba? So you see the landscape. So ikaw, alam mo rin kung ano yung magiging pattern in the future. If you want to write on that, you can do it easily, di ba? And then for innovators, it's a business strategy to maximize assets and recovery investment. Yeah, this one is from the point of view of usually the multinationals. No? So if you have IPs, they can recoup their investment. So kinds of IP, we have copyright in books, derived books, paintings, artworks, usually mga artistic work, literary and artistic works. Trademarks and service marks, geographic indications, industrial designs, patents, layout designs, okay. Geographical indication, mabilis na lang. Geographical indication, example, Bicol, Pili. So kung hindi siya, yung Pili mo is not from Bicol, I'm not sure, is there any other city na nag-grow yung Pili? Meron ba?
Samar.
Ah, okay. But then, hindi mo pwede gamitin Bicol kasi hindi siya from Bicol. So yun yung geographical indication. Industrial design, so ito yung for example, yan, ito, yung design ito that can be an industrial design. It can also be a trademark. It can also be an industrial design. So, ang maganda lang sa trademark kasi, meron siyang 3D trademark, which essentially covers the same aspect of your design as an industrial design. And then yung 3D mark kasi, perpetual yung renewal nun. But for industrial design, that's only as good for 15 years, total of 15 years, 5, total of 5, so 15 years. So, if I were to give an advice to a client, mag 3D mark ka na lang kaysa mag-industrial design. Unless, may mga unless lang yan, hindi pwede maging trademark. Yeah, design ng iPhone, yung registration number na yan, that's a registration issued by the Philippine Intellectual Property Office. Layout designs, honestly, I haven't seen one. Layout designs refer to the topography or yung design ng ICs, integrated circuits. I really don't. Meron bang ano dito ID? I don't see the point. Kasi if you have a design, probably that will have the maximum and most efficient design. Why would you create a design that will not give the maximum or the most efficient output just for the heck of it, diba? That doesn't make sense. So I haven't really seen one. I have not received any query from a client trying to secure protection over this. So maybe in other countries. Pero may batas yan ah, yung ano na to. Anyway. Pero common misconception, like I was in a meeting a few days ago with some people from the OST. When they say IP, ang IP sa kanila yung registered bank. registered patent, registered trademarks, registered everything. That's not accurate. Diba, sabi natin kanina, the moment that you create something, may IP siya, lalo na for copyright. So it need not be registered. Also, it can be a trade secret. It's considered intellectual property that can be protected. My favorite, Jenny knows that. Coke addict. I've been drinking Coke since high school, and buti na lang they have Coke Zero now. Oh my God, the first time I tried Coke Zero, sobrang different from the classic, right? I mean, such a blasphemy, why would you create the Coke Zero? But now, that's my concession, because there's just too much sugar in the classic regular Coke, so I drink Coke Zero. But Genevieve, the biotech person, tells me, you know, it's amino acid, so it's also harmful. I don't want to know, I just want to drink Coke. So, the secret formula is very valuable, one of the most valuable IP out there. Diba? Or you should register it, I didn't chat. Okay, so patents, it's any technical solution of a problem in any field of human activity. So it's actually essentially anything under the sun that is not prohibited by law and that is new, novel, inventive, and industrially applicable. So usually, when something is presented to me, the first thing that I do is go through the list of non-patentable inventions. And then that's easier to read that way. And then I say, it's a discovery, sorry, not patentable. It's a method for treatment of the human or animal body, not patentable. And then if it's not in any of the non-patentable inventions, then I check for the requirements for patentability. Is it new? Is it inventive? Is it industrially applicable? Most likely it's industrially applicable. So yun na yung question. Question na lang would be, is it novel? Or if it's inventive. So yeah, discoveries bawal, imagine, no? Yung mga easy ko to MC squared, mga ganon. Kung naging patentable, diba? So imagine if you are deprived of all this knowledge. And then schemes, okay? Or addition, yung patentable yan, diba? So we can add. Yung methods for treatment of the human or animal body, that's prohibited, that cannot be patented for, probably for, parang it's contrary to the morals, di ba? Kasi parang you cannot have monopoly over treatment of diseases, right? But there's a way to write claims such that actually you're claiming the same thing, a method of treatment, di ba? But if you have to write your claims in a different way. So, hinighlight ko lang yung what may be relevant to the group, which, I mean, I'm supposed to touch a bit on agriculture or biotechnology. So, plant varieties or animal breeds or essentially biological process for the production of plants or animals are not patentable. However, this prohibition will not apply to microorganisms and non-biological and microbiological processes. Hindi ko rin alam. So, we'll see that later. Okay. Also, yung mga plant varieties are protected under different law. Yung plant variety, yeah. Aesthetic creations, not patentable. Pwede yan sa copyright. Anything which is contrary to public order or morality. So, example ng public order morality, you were asked to do a patent search for a toxin-emitting organism. So obviously, hindi siya patentable kasi pwede siyang gamitin parang the biological warfare, mga ganyan. So hindi siya patentable. So mga example. Or sa trademarks naman ng mga curse, hindi pwede register. Hindi siya pwede register. Utility model is very similar to patent, but isa lang yung requirement niya. At dalawa lang requirement niya, novelty and the industrial applicability. So it need not be inventive. So mas madali ito. Example, sa mga handle ko na utility model, vary eh. Depends. Para some clients, over, what do you call this, chemical compositions. So medyo mahirap yun. Ginawa niya ng UM. Ang point niya kasi, mas madali yung makuha yung registration as compared to going through a patent examination. So, utility model has of protection for 7 years, the term of protection 7 years from filing of the application. It's non-renewable. So I guess this will work for inventions that have fast obsolescence. So it doesn't make sense to secure a patent protection kung mag-change din naman yung technology on that. Ayun, change yung technology, diba? So utility model yung ina-advise namin. And then others naman, yung mga socks, yung design ng socks, file your application using industrial design and industrial design and utility model registration. And the IPO granted both. So the client has protection over the design, the look, also on the functional aspect of the socks. Okay, so depends really. But for me, if it's something that is commercial value, then maybe you should go through a patent application process. In any case, you can convert your application from a patent to utility model and vice versa. Okay. Industrial design, we discussed it earlier. No need to go through that. Ano naman yan? Ano ba yung usual na ano sa university ng copyright? Manuals, right? Manuals. Copyright. I really don't... there's not much protection in copyright because what you can prohibit is the reproduction of the work in the same mode. So for example, si Sir took a picture earlier, ang output mo photo, pero akin to, hindi ito pwedeng gawin ng wala ng permission ko. Pero yung photo niya, pwede niya i-reproduce kasi photo niya yun eh. Things like that. So for example, ang pwede mo lang i-copyright, I guess I would recommend copyright if it cannot be patented, cannot be the subject of a utility model, registration, industrial design, so parang dulo ko na yung copyright. Ang positive lang pala, advantage ng copyright is that there was an amendment to the IP code relating to copyright where there's secondary infringement. Meaning, sino dito ang bumibili ng mga DVDs. Pirated. Oh, I used to do that before I became an IP lawyer. So, pirated DVDs. Yung pirated DVDs, ang pwede magbuli dyan, it's not only the creator of the pirated DVDs, but also the malls where they sell it. That's secondary infringement. So, yun yung strength ng copyright. If you have copyright, you can run after more people. As compared to patents and trademarks, mahirap yung secondary infringement. Dapat yung talagang gumawa ng pangawak niya lang. Pero sa copyright, lumalawak yung protection. So let's be careful, even the downloading, when you download without authority, the owner, for example, we had a client, company client, tapos yung mga employees niya, may nag-download pala ng 50 shades of gray. Dinownload, and nabuli siya, diba? So the liability attaches not just to the employee, but also to the employer. That's why the employer has to put in place policies that would show that they do not tolerate that, and that they will enforce. Hindi lang not tolerate, but that they will enforce any punishment against any infraction. So yun lang yung mahilap sa copyright. So may firewall na tayo ngayon. Bawal yung mga Facebook natin sa office and everything because nga, there might be some illegal, ang hirap naman ng illegal, unauthorized acts that are done and may render the employer liable, including the university. So, okay, so we go to biotech. Now here, I will just breeze through it because we're the experts in biotechnology. So, January 2018, the Intellectual Property Office came up with the guidelines on the examination of biotechnological applications. So, bago lang. It used to be that they use one examination manual for substantive examination for all inventions. So, now we have parang crafted a specific guidelines for biotech applications. So sabi natin kanina, plant varieties, animal breeds, essentially biological process for the production of plants or animals are excluded, diba? Ito yung relevant na exclusion, excluded subject matter that we mentioned earlier. So let's see how it plays out. So in the introduction of the guidelines, they mention unanticipated inventions. Do we use this in the industry? Unanticipated inventions. So anyway, sabi nila, it was never thought that biotech could manipulate either the plant or animal being, and therefore no one has ever thought of the need for evolving, etc., etc. My sense is that, you know what happened after the Vitita Long case? So there were some people who were saying that, does this mean that biotech inventions can no longer be protected in the Philippines? When they came up with this, they're like saying no, it can still be protected. So in fact, we have come up with the guidelines so that you will know what are eligible for patent protection. So in the same guidelines, they mentioned the seminal case of Diamond versus Chakrabarty. So sa Chakrabarty, tama ba yung term who came up? Parang isolated. He isolated a microorganism. He isolated a bacteria to degrade crude oil. So for oil spill siya. So sabi nila, although there are bacteria that can degrade crude oil, pero iba yung mechanism nung kanyang na-isolate na bacteria. So ang conclusion ng US Supreme Court is that alive, man-made microorganism is a non-naturally occurring composition and therefore may be patented. So even if it's alive, but it's not naturally occurring, then it can be patented. So, ang pinaka-ano doon, ang pinaka-firmy, ang pinaka-important doon would be non-naturally occurring. So, if there's human intervention, ay, di na. Kaya rin na si IPO magsabi, ay, hindi yan patentable. But with this, then, well, of course, this, I just have to tell you that US cases do not bind, of course, the examiners nor the Philippine courts. But they can be persuasive, no? Also, since we don't have a Philippine case on the matter, so it can go either way, diba? Also, the guidelines that were created by the IPO does not bind the courts also. It's an internal document, really, to guide the examiners. So, it will not bind the courts later on if somebody brings the issue to the Supreme Court. Diba? So after Diamond versus Chakrabarty, marami na nangyari, like the USPTO, the US Patent Trademark Office, the European Patent Office, the Japan Patent Office, they revised their guidelines to include nga the patentability of non-naturally occurring organisms. Tama ba yun? Yung organism, di ba dapat naturally occurring siya?
Naturally
modified, non-naturally occurring. There you go. So organism pa rin yun. Okay. Thank you. Yeah. So I copied some of the definitions that I think are important or relevant to us this afternoon from the guidelines. So for example, biotech inventions. Inventions concerning biological materials or the process. So aside from the material itself, it can also include the process of their production, modification, utilization. So biological material. Does it make sense? Is it consistent? Is the definition consistent with what's being used in the industry? Containing genetic information which can replicate directly. So, kung hindi niya kaya mag-replicate, hindi siya biological material.
Hindi siya alive.
Okay. So, biological materials include viruses. Ito naman yung replicate directly. Include viruses, nucleic acids, and antibodies. So you see so many applications allowed by the Philippine IPO relating to nucleic acids, antibodies, the right? Microorganisms, microbiological process. Because you will recall that in the prohibition among the non-patentable subject matter earlier, This is a exception to the exception. So, pwede yung microorganisms at saka microbiological process. Ang bawal biological process. So, magkaiba yun, microbiological and biological process. So, essentially biological process, that's a definition. In short, hindi yan pwede. Kasi it's essentially biological for the production of plants and animals. But while they created a separate guidelines for biotech applications, nevertheless, the same process pa rin. I would apply the same process. First, check if it's patent eligible. Diba? So it should neither be a discovery nor a product of essentially biological process. Yun lang yung lalaroin mo. Dapat hindi siya discovery. Kasi kung naturally occurring, discovery lang yun. Parang nahanap mo lang siya kasi naturally occurring. But the moment that there's human intervention, pwede na siya, patent eligible na siya. Patent eligible, but after that, you have to go through the same stringent requirements, novelty, inventiveness, industrial applicability. But it's not an additional requirement, because even for non-biotech applications, there has to be an enabling disclosure. Ibig sabihin, for example, it's this one, this is my invention. Everything has to be described in the description part, diba? And then so, whatever I claim, lahat ba tayo ay makita na ng patent application? May claim siya, diba? Yung claim na part, dapat may support siya dun sa description natin. So what I usually do when I draft application, I start with the claims. So interview with the researcher, then you start with the claims, then I just copy that, list it, and then put it in my description. And then we flesh out mo na lang siya. So to avoid any office action on no, parang lack of enabling disclosure. So it's required in all patent applications. It's just that for biotech application, if the application refers to a nucleotide, dapat yung sequence ng doon mismo sa body na ano natin, yung description natin. Tapos kung mahaba, kailangan may format pa siyang kailangan si IPO, si attaching siya sa likod ng description. There's a format, I'm not familiar with the format, para may software ata for that they use. And then, for microorganisms naman, is that a culture of such must have been deposited in a depository institution before you file the application, right? You require this if the microorganism cannot be described sufficiently. So probably if it's something new, then hindi siya kayang ulitin ng public yung invention mo such that you need to submit or deposit a sample of the culture before you file the application. But if it's something that can be sufficiently described in words, okay lang, you need to deposit. Stem cells, kasi yung stem cells na yun, kaya siguro sinama nila yung stem cells sa guidelines. Ang sabi lang, in evaluating applications relating to stem cells, ang critical is the source of the stem cell. Whether the use of the embryo as a base material involved direct destruction or not. So, meron silang matters direct destruction. I'm not so familiar with stem cells, so ibig sabihin may stem cell na galing sa embryo. Pag ganon, hindi siya patentable. Diba? Hindi siya patentable. Is that good? I mean, because you would think that stem cells kasi parang fresh or something.
It's an ethical debate because stem cells, they are very potent, so they can like multiply and become other types of cells, so that's why they're very
useful. Very useful, no?
Yeah, very useful. So the problem is the best source of stem cells are embryonic cells.
Right.
You have to kill, basically, an embryo. So it's very, but it's really hard to understand. Fortunately, they found out that you can get stem cells from the placenta. So that case, okay.
So that's why they're specifying
that you can't use the one from the embryo, but if it's from the placenta or from the embryo.
Right, yes. Because now earlier you said that non-patentable, yes, diba? Oh. yung parang anything that is contrary to public order and morality. So, which of course is very subjective. But right now, this is where we stand. At least may rule silang bawal kapag ginito. So yan. Okay, so meron silang technical na approximately 8-bit post-fertilization. Ganon. Okay. So yan yung bawal. Yan yung hindi pwede. Hindi siya patentable. So, with respect to plants and animals naman, plants and animals are patentable if the technical feasibility of the invention is not confined to a particular animal plant or variety. Meaning, even your first variety, plant variety, ang gamitin mo. Pero, may maganda silang drawing dun eh. Sa, yan. From the guidelines, which they also lifted from another source. So, example niya, if you refer to the apples, that's a variety. Or, hindi ka pwede magkaroon monopoly over that. But if it's a plant containing a gene X for increasing vitamin C content, which can be applied to the appropriate, siguro, appropriate na plants, that one, you can patent that. But if you identify a specific variety, or for example, a desired characteristic of a specific variety, medyo kanilang red flag yan. So it has to be something that does not relate to a specific variety. So, aside from the plant or the animal itself, the process for the production of plants or animals are also not patentable. It makes sense, diba? But we don't know in the future, it's changing, the laws also changing. So, example niya, this example is from the guidelines. Method for the production of plants having trait X comprising crossing plants A and B and selecting progeny having marker X. Kasi sabi niya, yan naman yung usual na ano eh, yung explanation, that's the usual way, di ba, of reproduction, ano ba tawag, reproduction? Breeding, okay. So it's patent ineligible. However, if there's an additional step, di ba, parang ganun lang, if it's not surely occurring, not patentable. If there's human intervention, arguably patentable. Hindi ka pa sure, but arguably patentable. Kasi, paminsan, even if there's an additional step, if the step is not relevant, or if it's not significant pala, and does not really affect the output, then it can be deemed an essentially biological process. So, matas din yung plants pwede yun. O yan. So, sinama ko na rin yung public order variety, yung catch-all phrase natin kanina. So, processes for cloning human beings, bawal pa. Bawal pa. Next time, ba pwede na. Processes for modifying the germline, genetic identity of human beings, bawal din. Use of human embryos for industrial and commercial purposes, bawal. May cause them suffering, bawal din yun. Talagang ilagay pa nila. Para mabuti ng klara tayo. Para. So, any biological material method able to seriously endanger human beings, animals, or plant life, or able to cause serious damage to health or environment, including its use. The guidance is actually very new. There are many typographical errors, pa. So I'm not sure maybe they will review the guidelines again. Okay, so that's it. So yung mga bawal, or all else pwede. Okay, kasi ganun naman yung batas. Pag hindi enumerate, pwede. Kapag hindi enumerate, edi pasok ka dun sa exclusion, right? Oh, another thing also, sometimes when you craft your your IP strategy, so for example, we have this plant in Taiwan, and they came up with a breed. Okay, yung breed nila, well, may desired characteristic. But it turned out later on that the most effective way of protecting it is not through plant variety or plant variety act or patents, but through the trademarks. Because apparently nga, the consumers will buy the name. So my desired trait siya, people got used to it. The brand had the recall, so people would buy it. So they license out the name, the brand. So lahat kayo na pwedeng, kunyari lang, gintong ani. Lahat ganito yung characteristic and you want to use our brand, you pay us royalties. So, naging trademark yung issue, hindi na siya patent, hindi na rin siya plant variety. So, there is no hard and fast rule, but you just have to study what would be most effective given your market, your target market. Okay, that's it.